Welcome you once again in geological knowledge. So in the previous video we have talked about very important questions or the very important topic that is related to sedimentology or the sedimentary rocks, in which we have talked in detail the objective questions which are generally asked in the examination from the basic part and the structures and composition, structure, texture and composition of sedimentary rocks, as well as some important very important sedimentary rocks also. Okay, so we have talked about already on 7 or 8 videos, now 6 or 7 videos on the sedimentary rocks or the sedimentology part, and now we will talk about the importance of or the important questions related to the metamorphic petrology or the metamorphic rocks. Okay, so we all know that is, as in the previous video we have also discussed, that the schedule of BHU PET examination 2020 has been released. Okay, an exam date has also been released, so you can check it out on the website, or if it's not available, so you can wait for 5 to 10 days. I think 17th of August they will release the, you can get the timetable from the website. Okay, so let's start our today's discussion, that is based on the metamorphic rocks. Okay, so let's start. So these are the MCQs. So this is the very first video on the metamorphic petrology, and that deals with the metamorphism and their factors. Okay, so what is the metamorphism and what are their salient factors or the agents of metamorphism, we call them, that are very important or that decides the metamorphism process or the metamorphic process. Okay, so very first question, that is very basic, and what is the term used to express the process which is responsible for all the changes that take place in original rock under the influence of changes? Okay, so options are hibernation, herbination, or the metamorphism, or the metagenesis. So we all know that is the option is metamorphism, but we must understand firstly that what is the metamorphism. Okay, so or we must understand firstly what is metamorphic rocks. Okay, so in very basic language, or in the zero line definition of metamorphic rock, that we can define, or we can define in terms the rocks which are made up of metamorphic minerals, that is known as metamorphic rocks. Okay, so that is very easiest definition, that is for the metamorphic rock to occur, the minerals which are taking place in the formation of metamorphic rocks, they can be metamorphic in origin or the metamorphic minerals. Okay, so metamorphic rocks which are formed from the metamorphism of the older rocks, when they are subjected to increased temperature, pressure and shearing stress at a considerable depth in the earth's crust. And the older rocks, they can be either sedimentary rocks or the igneous, or sometimes they can be metamorphic rocks also. Because metamorphism or the metamorphism means change in the form of a particular object, that is known as metamorphosed product, or the meta means change and morph means composition or in the shape of the rock. Okay, and they can be, they are formed at the considerable depth in the earth's crust, and the older rocks we are talking about, so they can be either sedimentary, igneous or metamorphic, sometimes they can also be in origin. And during the metamorphism, the recrystallization that take place essentially in the solid state, and new minerals and new textures are produced subsequently. Okay, so that is known as the metamorphism or the metamorphic rocks, we can call them. Okay, so the question is dealing with the terms used to express the processes which are responsible for all the changes that take place in original rock under the influence of changes, that is known as metamorphism. Okay, so metamorphism is the term which is used to express the processes responsible for all the changes that take place in an original rock under the influence of changes in the surrounding conditions of temperature, pressure and chemically active fluids. Okay, so correct option here is option C, metamorphism. Next question is, second question dealing with the factor not affecting metamorphism is. Okay, so this is very important question, that is the agents of metamorphism. So agents which bring about the metamorphic changes in the rocks, these are heat means temperature, uniform pressure, directive pressure, pressure or stress, and the chemically active fluid. So heat or the temperature and pressure, that is again divided into two parts, that is the uniform pressure and directed pressure. And directed pressure can also be called as stress sometimes, and chemically active fluids. Okay, so now you can easily answer this question, that is wind that doesn't affect the metamorphic process. So factor affecting the metamorphism of the rocks, they are the temperature, pressure and chemically active fluids, and wind condition that may not affect, that don't affect the metamorphism in any way. Okay, so correct option, option A. Next question is, factors are also called as the metamorphic factors are also called as. So we have already pressure and chemically active fluids. Okay, fourth one is the temperature up to which minerals in rock are stable. So what is the temperature up to which the rocks, the minerals in a particular rocks are stable? 100 degrees, 50 degrees, 500 degrees or the 200 degrees. So rocks are made up of the minerals that are normally stable at the temperature below 200 degrees Celsius. And however, when the temperature around these rocks that changes due to one reason or the other reasons, the mineral composition of the rock undergoes some changes. And that process is known as metamorphism actually. Okay, so correct option here is option D. Okay, so 200 degrees Celsius. Question number 5 is, any given rock at some depth below the surface is subjected to pressure from how many sources? Means, suppose a rock has been given at some depth below the surface, that rock is subjected to pressure from how many sources? 1, 2, 3 or 4. So we all know, that is the any given rock at some depth below the earth's surface that is subjected to pressure from the two sources. Okay, so that is the firstly the load of the overlying burden. Okay, so the particular rock that is occurring into the interior of the earth, so obviously there will be the pressure of the overlying rocks or the burden of the overlying rocks or the load of the overlying rocks, and also secondly the crustal movement. So the movement in the crustal part, that is also taking place. So that's why these two sources, they will be subjected or they will lead to the process of metamorphism. Option B is the right answer. Sixth one is, what is the pressure exerted during the crustal movement called as? Okay, so you must understand, there are two terms, uniform pressure and directed pressure. So what is uniform pressure? So the static pressure is known as uniform pressure, and the static pressure on the rocks, that is caused by the deep burial. Okay, so pressure because of the deep burial of the rocks, that is static pressure, and this pressure is due to the weight of the overlying rocks. Okay, we have already talked, that is the rocks are occurring at a greater depth, so that means the overlying rocks burden, that will also act as a pressure. Okay, and when the temperature gradient that exists within the earth, the static pressure is usually associated with the higher temperature. Okay, so whenever the temperature gradient that exists within the earth's surface, the static pressure or the uniform pressure that usually associate with the higher temperature. Okay, and the directed pressure, so directed pressure or the stress, we can also call them stress, that operates during the folding movement and which accompany the mountain building processes. Okay, so directive pressure, which are related to the mountain building process or the static is the stress conditions, and generally directed pressure that play an important role in near the earth surface, and as the depth increases, the effect of the directed pressure that decreases. Okay, so as soon as the depth increases, the effect of the directed pressure that decreases, and that of uniform pressure that increases. Okay, so you must understand that the variation in the temperature with the depth, sorry, the variation in the pressure with the depth. So when the depth increases, the directed pressure or the stress conditions that decrease, but the uniform or the static pressure that increases because of the overlying pressures, the overlying burden. Okay, now we come back to our question. What is the pressure exerted during the crustal movement called as? Indirect pressure, secondary pressure, directed pressure, or the primary pressure? So now you can easily answer this question. The pressure from the orogenic activity that is generally lateral or the horizontal and is commonly termed as the directed pressure. Okay, so option B will be the right option. Seventh one is, what is the direction of pressure exertion in load metamorphism called as? Sorry, what is the direction of pressure exertion in load metamorphism is? Vertical, horizontal, inclined, horizontal, or vertical? That is vertical in nature. The load of the overlying burden, obviously the rocks are occurring in the earth's interior, so obviously they will be vertical in nature. Okay, so that's why the load of the overlying burden that acts generally exerts pressure in a vertical direction, and the process of change in the structure of the rock that is often referred as the load metamorphism. Okay, because of the uniform pressure or the static pressure, the load that the weight of the overlying rocks or the load of the overlying rocks that increases with the depth. So option A, vertical, is the right answer. Eighth one is, pore fluid play important role in metamorphism. So there is a statement here, that is pore fluid that play an important identify, or you have to just tell whether it's this statement is true or false. So we all know that is the true. Okay, so chemically active fluids or the gases, chemically active fluid and particularly the gases, when passed through the pore spaces of the rocks, they bring about changes in their original composition. And the source of these chemical agents is generally the intrusive igneous rock body within the country rocks. Okay, so pore fluids which are initiated by the intrusive igneous rocks. And you can also see in the description box, that is presence or the absence of the chemically active fluids within the body of the rock, the pore fluids or around them plays very important role in the processes of all types of metamorphism. Okay, so a statement, pore fluid play important role in the metamorphism, that is absolutely true. Next one is, ninth one, water in which form is considered as single most important agent? Solid, liquid, gaseous, or the solid and liquid? So water in the form of steam is considered as the single most important agent, and the water that may be present in the minerals as water of the crystallization or simply as pore fluid. Okay, or it can also be supplied externally by the magmatic bodies. Okay, so this gaseous component, sorry, the water or the water in the form of the steam, that is considered as the single most important agent that we have already discussed. And the mineral as the water, the pore pressure, the pore spaces present in the rocks or the water crystallization or the simply as pore fluid, it may be supplied externally by the magmatic bodies. Okay, so option C is the correct option. Okay, so gaseous state or the gaseous form of the water, that is considered as the single most important agent. Next one is, which rock show several degrees of metamorphism? Okay, so which types of rocks, they show severe degree of metamorphism? Situated near the plate boundaries, situated inside the boundaries, situated at the center of the plates, irrespective of the place, the degree is same everywhere. Okay, so you have to tell the correct option. So the correct option here is situated near the plate boundaries. Okay, so basically the rocks which are situated near the plate boundaries or within the geosynclinal belts of are especially very prone to directed pressure and often show severest degree of metamorphic changes. Okay, so rocks which are occurring at the near the plate boundaries, they are very severe or prone to highest degree of metamorphism or metamorphic changes. Okay, so correct option here is option A. 11th one is, metamorphism can also happen about 850 degrees. So statement is that metamorphism can also happen about 850 degrees. So you have to say degree Celsius, you have to tell whether it's true or false. Okay, so it's generally believed that the most metamorphic rocks or the metamorphic changes in the rocks, they are induced by the heat factor which take place between 300 to 850 degrees Celsius. And some components of the rock, they may actually start melting at that temperature, and hence rock formed from their resolidification, that shall be included in the category of igneous rocks. Okay, because that at the highest temperature or the temperature range, that 850 degrees which has been mentioned in the question, the components of rocks, they actually start melting rather than getting deformed or getting metamorphosed. Okay, so melting process start taking place, and hence the rocks formed from their solid resolidification, they shall be included in category of igneous rocks rather than the metamorphic rocks. Okay, so the statement which was given, metamorphism can also happen about 850 degrees Celsius, so that is false. Okay, so this was our discussion about some very important questions or very basic questions related to the metamorphic petrology, and in the next video we will talk about the other questions, important questions related to metamorphic petrology, like the processes of metamorphism, the types of metamorphism. Okay.